Hello there, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the SSCIT broadcast. This week I will be streaming and recording some 8 replays in no particular order. And the first of those replays is Banana Brain versus Purple Wave, two Protoss giants doing quite well on the ladder and on the 8 tournament itself as well. Later I will take a look at the tournament scores and we will see how did they fare. I think Purple Wave was the winner, but I don't want to reveal any more than that. So that's a pretty standard bowling option, no proxy gateways or anything, and the meeting of the scouting probes, they even smooched a little, meeting of the scouting probes in the middle. That probe blocking is interesting. Can they effectively block that probe? Or I guess that probe can just mineral walk or something up there. And yeah, they are blocking the scouting probe. Now that's the first. I didn't see. Although you are pretty pressed to spare those two probes that early, so that means maybe Vanilla Brain is doing something sneaky and. He does not want Purple Wave to see that advanced sneakiness. In the meantime, Purple Wave has a wall of quite well, it's not a complete wall, but kind of a wall. And not much is happening. A lot of zealots for Purple Wave. I think Purple Wave can just break through. And the first goon is out. And the scouting SCV, I think, just died. And Banana Brain not in a good position, Citadel of Alun, I think this will be a Dark Templar play, but yeah, maybe that was the cause of the sneakiness, but I am not sure. No, that's not a Templar archive, so maybe not. Maybe not. In the meantime, the zealots are breaking in, and yeah, we have a problem here. No, the zealots are retreating actually. I think they could have done a lot more damage, devastated the worker line, but Purple Wave didn't think so. So, nice wound micro, and with the workers, they can do a lot of damage. And the time to press this advantage has been pressed a bit. Although Purple Wave is still quite happily off, and yeah, the army is on Purple Wave's side, I mean the army size advantage, and what do we have here? No, that's just a pilot. So nothing particularly interesting so far. I think this will just end with Purple Wave running in and killing everything with overwhelming number of zealots, and there is the Dark Templar from Purple Wave. I thought Banana Brain was going for that, but no, Purple Wave did, and there is the Dark Templar sneaking in, absolute no detection for Banana Brain whatsoever, and yeah, decimating the worker line has just begun. At this point, Banana Brain is kind of screwed, the forge is out, that was probably a cannon trying to get constructed, but you don't have the minerals, you don't have the workers anymore, and this is a well-timed Dark Templar attack by Purple Wave, and very nicely done. A short but interesting game. GG. Okay, so this next game is Bunker Boxer versus UI Alberto Bot. And yeah, as I said, we can have a pretty good guess what Bunker Boxer bot will do. And UI Alberto bot is a long time baseline bot. A lot of people have worked and worked on it. It is the granddaddy of all bots. And I just realized my screen is a little bit screwed. So let me remedy that mistake in just a second. And yeah, there you go. Scouting drone out and scouted something, and UI Alberto bot is out with 6 links. Do we have anything? No, just 5 workers, so this is a 5 pool. So that means if this is successfully defended, then Bunker Boxer has a pretty good chance of winning. Well, that's the common wisdom, and worker advantage is on Boxer's side. And yeah, I think that will be the end of it. Although some zerglings are still streaming in, but at this point the production is just too much for UI Alberto Bot. Nice effort, but we can clearly see that this will not work. Well, at least that's my prediction at the moment. But let's wait for the end. It is not over until it is over. Nice protection of the Marines by the SCVs. SCVs are quite tough early game. Not for long, but still they can effectively shield and screen these poor Marines. I wonder when we will see the first bunker, if we do at all. And maybe time is just about now for that, or I don't know. No, this is just an SCV and a marine attack. No, there is the bunker, and yes, that's a bunker, but it's quite unnecessary because the marines just kill everything without the bunker. But better safe than sorry. Four marines in the bunker, and at this point this is just over. I'm revealing a strange fact. There is quite a lot left of this game, so let me speed this up because this is effectively gone, and this has glitched out a lot. What are these guys firing at? Maybe the larvae? I don't know. Oh, this is wacky. Yes, that was the larvae. And they seem to want to go into that one bunker, all of them, instead of just blasting this damned hatchery down. And yeah, this is 124 times the speed, and this has ended predictably. Let's jump into the next game. So it is Dachin versus Iron. Iron is a veritable old bot, very very good Terran, and Dachin is a Locutus fork, and I don't know how different it is than Locutus. And I think I saw in the forums or rather Discord that most Locutus forks are from an earlier version, as the license for Locutus was a little bit different, and there has been a few shallow forks which has been disqualified for basically being Locutus and nothing much else. But let's seize that unpleasant thought and see what's rushing up to. I don't know, this gate replacement is a little bit weird for me, but maybe just forward choke point is strengthened here. I don't know. And what do we have? We have two zealots, but they are just guarding the entrance. And one watcher is out, which can be bad news for the zealots. Properly microed, they can basically kite zealots to oblivion, but not to fear, because Dragoon boys are here, and they perform quite well against the watchers. Although draining their shields, watchers perform quite well because everything deals full damage to shields. But they can't stand against dragoons on their own, so they can still be supporting units. And let's not forget the spider mines, which is an effective zoning tool. At this moment, I don't think we have an observatory, or do we have an observatory? I don't see any, but we do have a fleet beacon. That probably means, no, that's means carriers. I thought that's for Corsair stuff, but no, that is carriers. And this is a one base carrier, two base carrier for Dachin, which can work, especially because the Terran player has basically no anti-air, and that one marine will not stop a carrier attack. I'm pretty damn confident about that fact. And there's more turtling and carriering up. I mean, if it works, it works. I didn't know that any bot did that besides Xin, but Dachin or maybe Locutus has this build. And like I said, if it works, then it is justified. And I'm suspecting that there is some opponent learning must maybe in play here, because it is pretty clear that Iron is not prepared for that, and Dachin is not did not scout Iron properly. So that means that Dachin is either just throwing the throwing something at the wall and see if it sticks, or expecting Iron to perform this tactic because of learnings. Either way, let's speed this up a little bit. Either way, I think this will be a devastating model. Only one carrier, that's a little bit bold, that can be defended at this point. I don't know if Iron can or will defend, but apparently not, but it could have been defended, let's say that. But yeah, more tanks, let's take a look, producing an armory. Too little, too late. I don't think the Goliaths will come out in time, although we do have 3 factories, and that's, that can produce a lot, but we don't have the resources. That's the problem here. We simply not enough resources. One Goliath is out, but we have 6 carriers at this point, so it's the classic case of too little, too late. So it just works, ladies and gentlemen, and yeah, this game is over. GG Dachin, and let's hop into the next game. So it's Locutus versus Xiao Yi. Xiao Yi is a new bot, and I didn't really look up if it's a fork on an entirely new production by some presumably Chinese guys, or at least Far Eastern. And I think it's some Chinese university project, but I'm not entirely sure. Anyway, it is Locutus which is doing something. Do we have? No, I thought that was a glitch, but no. So pretty standard. It's a barracks and refinery, early refinery. I must suspect that this could be a bioplay, but at this point it's too early to tell. And Locutus is going for goons, because that is what Locutus does. And do we have any kind of... yeah, we have gateway here. A little bit weird place. I would have placed it a little bit closer. I don't know if Locutus scouted properly. I missed the scouting probe, and I can't tell, but there was... there's probably no scouting going on. I don't know, I can't tell. So it's a proxy 2 gate, and it's a bunker. Judging by the marine count, this bunker is not empty. And I was wrong, this is not a bioplay, this is a get out tank as fast as possible play. So quite the opposite, but we have Dark Templars, and they are the, can be the denies very quickly. Where are the Dark Templars? And do we have any kind of hold there at the Dark Templars? The place where they shouldn't be, according to the Terran player. The workers don't really do anything besides dying, but they do that quite well, so at least there is that. And yeah, this is just a very well-timed Dark Templar rush, or not rush, attack, something, Dark Templar. Dark Templaring. So I think this is this game is concluded. So another quick one. Let's see something else. So it is Microwave versus Microwave, and you might be wondering why the replays from 8 were late, and the cause of this is because the first time the games were run, there was an error and the results were invalid, and the games had to be rerun. So now we have an actual collection of replays which we can cast, and I had the honor to do that first. And maybe since there are a lot of replays, Nepeta will cast some next week for you. It is Microwave versus Microwave, and Microwave is expanding quickly. Spawning pool, probably. Yes, spawning pool extractor. In the meantime, Microwave is just 2-gating it like a boss. And there is... no, that's not an access. And Yeah, not much going on scouting, although this probe is repeatedly scouting this one nexus, which is not really the point of scouting. So E for effort, but yeah, let's recalibrate that. And the first few Zerglings, I presume, yes, are out, and they don't even try to chase down the probe. I like seeing that, because the probe, age-old custom of probe chasing must be eradicated. It is not interesting anymore, and you usually can't catch the probe. So it's 5 Zealots versus 6 Lings. My money is on the Zealots at this point, and what do we have? McCree is saving minerals. I think this was meant to be an expansion. That's quite a lot of minerals. I don't know what's what McCree is planning. Only producing a drone, and this is another gateway. That is it. I think that something went sideways. I think this was meant to be saved for a nexus or not. I don't know. I'm not McCree. And in the meantime, a Spire is up, so we will have the Mutalisk Harass Cobite quickly. And only one Sunken, which is not enough to repel even this small expeditionary force from Macrave. And the Sixlings, well, they are even less adequate for that challenge. So, Sixlings, I mean, Mutalisks are already out, but they are not grouped tightly together. There are some dragoons. They can't repel, but I don't know. They maybe can repel the Mutalisk, but the Mutalisk will deal a lot of damage. They didn't reach the worker lines, and the goon count now is sufficient. So I think the Mutalisk play maybe wasn't the best choice. And what is interesting is McCrave is not sneaking around lines. The Mutalisks are flying into the base straight away, and they encounter goon. If they encounter goons, they just retreat. In the meantime, if they just go around, they could do a lot of damage, but that's not a logic that Microwave has. However, another logic that Microwave doesn't have is recognizing that there are a looming Mutalisk threat, and yeah, you shouldn't leave your base unguarded. Maybe throw up some cannons or something. It is a base trade, but this is the third of Microwave, and this is the first of Microwave. The other way around. So this was the third of Microwave, and the main base of Microwave, and that is not a good trade. Even level, all the mutants are eventually killed. I'm wondering, but Microwave probably, you know, Microwave will recover, because Microwave can break through here, and I don't see much defense here. So it was a calculated risk, or maybe just luck, but in the end, I think this will turn out better for Macrave. Any rebuilding? No rebuilding. There are no workers left for Macrave. So either this army wins or it is over. But it seems that this army can indeed win, because Microwave has no standing army to speak of. That was a creep colony, I believe. And yeah. Nice risk taking and evaluating by Macrave. I don't know how intentional was this, probably not very, but still, I must commend the resolution of this. And GG Macrave, let's have the next game. The next game is Steamhammer, the granddaddy of a lot of bots versus Iron. I know we had Iron this cast already, but there was only 10 or 11 bots this week, but not this week, on participating in aid. So there will be some redundancy, but there are quite a lot of combinations possible, so stay tuned. So with that completely unnecessary intro, let's jump to this game. And that is a supply depot in a weird place, and I can't figure out what's the goal here. Maybe some kind of walling effort, but I don't know. That's a weird place for a supply depot. And is that that's a bunker, barracks, I mean, I always confuse those two. So I thought that was a command center, but no, alas, it's not. In the meantime, Steamhammer is properly hatchering out. Expanding as a Zerg. And let's see what these genderbots are up to. Nothing much happening. That's surely a spawning pool. Yes, two hatch spawning pool. In the meantime, Iron is building the first factory. No significant army to speak of for either player, so we don't see any rushes. I wonder if these Zerglings will try to attempt anything. Yes, they are doing not smart things behind this supply depots, and this is a behavior which is present in built-in AI as well. If you at least what I remember, if you put up a wall of supply depots, they just don't attack it, and if your bot is doing that, then that's maybe a problem. I don't know if it is the same thing, but still, I can speculate. Nice vulture harass, and they are quite adeptly found the blind spot of this sunken colony here, and the hydras just don't advance. And I think they should. Hydras can speed a lot on those vultures, and they are they have the numerical advantage, even with the reinforcements, I think. But Steamhammer is just defending that sunken colony for no reason, and the gas miner drones dying in droves. And nice mine sweeping action. Not one hydralisk died to a mine hit. I must commend that. But there is a tanky boy. So, but do we have siege mode? Yes, we do. So, it is a matter of time until, yes, until the blasting begins. But we have a counter here. We have Steamhammer's Mutalisk Force. Okay, this game is starting to get interesting. Both players seem to react to the other, and this is emergent gameplay. Ladies and gentlemen, I like to use big words. And the Mutalisk scare the crap out of these poor tanks. And do we have any significant anti-air? Not at the moment, just one marine. Do we have any in production? Via missile turrets somewhere, probably in the main base. Yes. Well, Iron has its priorities straight. You got to protect your main base first. I think that's a good choice. Let's just think of the previous game with Microwave and Microwave. And yes, they couldn't do it better. The missile turrets are just in time. I wonder if this is a drop, probably not. No, this is just a scouting overlord. I must say, this base is quite vulnerable to a drop, just right about now, but no, we don't have the technology to drop, and no, that's not transport capability, that's just fast moving overlord capability. And yeah, the mutas arrive, the land army of Iron is decimated. So Iron is on a bit of a bind, and Steamhammer turned this around nicely. So let's see how this develops. But this is not over. What is in production? Vultures and the very. No, you should not do that. You should have something that can shoot into the air up to just somehow scare away these flappy boys. And no, vultures are not the answer here. And but Iron seems to think so. Iron is committed to making vultures and making mistakes. Well, it's not over yet. But Steamhammer is expanding yet again, taking the mineral only here, taking this fourth base. Well, third or fourth, depends on how you look at it. Is it a base if it doesn't have any gas? 10 out of 9 Zergs say no, but yeah, no, this is not turning out great for Iron. Steamhammer has the micro and the macro advantage both. The Mutalisks have free reign, they are just gathering in numbers, and Mutalisks are much more dangerous in larger numbers. They are not as dangerous in small one or two contingents. I don't know where I was going with this, but anyway, still, vultures are out, they are relentlessly mining up the map, but minesweeping is going on, and this is quite a futile effort, as there is always overlord cover, and even if when it is no overlord cover, the hydras are quite good at minesweeping, as you can see here. Every now and then, of course, they catch a mine hit, but not as many as you would expect. So, nice minesweeping action. I quite like this, the micro of these hydralisks, and let's slow this down to 1x speed. Still a lot of vultures. I don't know why is so many, why is Iron so adamant of making vultures. You need Goliaths or something. And yes, I think that's Erlings. I thought those were drones. The mines, oh, that was almost a nice mine hit. Dark Swarm, this is getting into the end game, and with Dark Swarm you have no means of damaging these units. I mean, literally no means, as only splash or melee damage is affecting units under Dark Swarm, and the Terran player has neither at this point. Although, for that to be effective, you have to stay under the Dark Swarm, which is not what these units are doing at the moment. So, yes, and that nice plague, and whew, that was a nice mine hit. No tanks, though. I'm wondering why don't we have tanks? We need more tanks. And this is just a standoff. Let's speed this up. I think eventually Steamhammer will just run in and absolutely devastate anything. And you shouldn't stand on your own mines, that's quite detrimental to your army's health. Let's see when the run-in will happen. Production is just going bonkers for Iron. Mutalisk flying in, Mutalisk count is 13, which is not as high as it could be, but they can outfight missile turrets now, and we have quite a lot of upgrades, even Ultralisk upgrades, but no Ultralisk to speak of yet, even one queen. What is this queen doing? Hey queenie, what are you doing? I think Steamhammer is just having fun at this point. Although I'm having a hard time imagining how would a bot do that, but still, Steamhammer is just absolutely taking the map, another base, and there are the Ultralisks. Although they can't quite catch Vultures, well, they just did, but usually they don't. They don't really get damage from Vultures either, so yeah, in the meantime, Zerglings are running in. Do we have? Yeah, we have the Adrenal Glands upgrade. This is basically decided, and this was decided for a while now. Nice plays from Iron, but this one goes to Steamhammer. Let's take a little bit of a look into the results of it. As you can see, it's Protoss domination all the way, Loctus Purple with Banana Berry Nashin, and then the Zerg block, Steamhammer, ZZK bot, Microwave, Iron, ZAOE, MacRave, which is surprisingly, pretty surprisingly low, UI Arbiter bot, AITP, a relatively new bot, or I haven't heard about that bot, and Bunker Boxer, and there are nice cross tables and everything. As you can see, there were 120 games played with every matchup. So that's quite a lot of games to choose from. So with that, I think I will just cast AITP versus ZZK bot at this point, because they are the lesser featured bots, let's say that. Let's get into it. AITP is a Terran bot, it looks like, and with that, Zizi Cabot is on course of one. Nick is on the ladder, on the SSEIT ladder, and I don't know yet, he's probably not on the same ladder. So, let's see, EITP is going for a rolling off here, rolling off refinery, and last time I predicted this is a beginning of a bio play, I was wrong, so now I'm guessing this is a beginning of a mech play. Oh, that wall was not Zergling proof. Yes, your Terran analysis or rolling libraries need some work, and I think this is just a 4 pool. Oh, that is bad. Losing to a 4 pool always feels bad, and even though I myself have a 4 pool bot, I'm having deepest condolences to AITP at this point, and let's just maybe have another replay from these gentle bots. So this time the opponent is Banana Brain, and I'm not really predicting that AITP will win, because Banana Brain is quite a strong bot, but still maybe not getting rushed is a better outcome. So let's see, do we get rushed or not? And same opening that suggests hard-coded opening for me, and this wall is not a zealot proof, I can tell. Although I'm not sure this was meant to be a wall at all, or maybe it was meant to be a wall but wasn't completed in time in the last game. Well, be that as it may, in the meantime, cybernetic score and two blocking probes, and that is a nice thing from Banana Brain. Did we just see something die here? Let me rewind the wheel of time. Yes, that was an SCV, and I think that SCV died here, but I only saw the dying animation, and yes, that SCV just died. And yeah, and this SCV, is it a scouting SCV? It is carrying gas, so it was pulled from the refiner. No, you should not do that. I think these bots just randomly select an SCV to scout, and you shouldn't randomly select an SCV to scout. Gas income is quite crucial, and you can speed it up like you can do with minerals. So, second scouting SCV this time, think better of it and not engaging this zealot here. And a robotics facility along with Templar Archives here that that suggests to me something, a shuttle and something like a Dark Templar drop. Is that something that people do? Probably, I don't know. And no academy, so we don't have a compensation or any capability for detecting invisible units. Oh dear, as Nepeta would say. And no engineering bay. Yep, and those Dark Templars are on the way. Unfortunately, I can't see into this shuttle, but I have a pretty good guess what this shuttle contains, and it is completely undetected, and just the Dark Templars of Doom are arriving. Oh, it is so bad to see. Academy is under construction, but it is too late. There will be no missile turrets, there will be no combat station, there will be nothing. Nicely executed, but in the meantime, maybe the Terran army can be breakthrough, as Banana Brain a little bit neglected his defenses, but no, two goons are out, and one tank, two vultures versus two goons. It can go either way at this point, but this base is probably last, but the second tank is screaming in. Siege mode is done, but it will be probably too long, and the Dark Templars still have free reign. There is no more income from EITP, and yeah, you can just make another Dark Templar and use that defensively. Yes, although Banana Brain is just attacking with that Dark Templar. I think the main aim of these Dark Templars is the main base itself of EITP, but as a side effect, they just repel the attack as well. So, nice try. We saw a little bit advanced play now, but you were not prepared for the Dark Templar plays. Let's see something else. So it's ZLE versus ZZK bot, and this time in a different deck. Let's see what will happen here. ZLE also I still don't know much about that bot. ZZK bot, I'm familiar somewhat, but I don't really know what kind of builds it uses. Scouting SCV, not really any way to avoid that, and that's a 4. That is a 4 pool, and yeah, this will be decided quickly. Nice work of defense from ZOE, and they just devastate the attacking Sturglings. And no siege from ZZK bot. ZZK bot is committed to the 4 pool play. I think this will end predictably. There is even a bunker, and two Zerglings can't really blast down a bunker. They can't really reach it even. And this is just sending Zerglings as they spawn. One defensive sunken colony, which is an interesting choice. You only have two workers now. That's not enough for well anything. I think there should be something. If even if you go for a 4 pool, you should switch if it does not work for after a certain time. Interesting building placement, and I think this command center is planned to be floated down, or maybe it's just horribly misplaced. I hope we will see the resolution of that. Yes, it is floated down, nicely done, and this map lends itself well to that strategy. And I have to comment that this is something, well, I'm not saying it rarely seen, but not that often maybe. And it is a matter of time, because no workers and no army for ZZK bot. ZOE taking its sweet time to MS well, a lot of Goliaths for some reason, and even pining up the base, but eventually they will just attack and kill absolutely everything. I think you should have done that a little bit earlier, but still, a win is a win. GG ZOE, and let's jump into the next game. Up next in the random selection of games, it's UI Alberto Bot versus Purple Wave, another PvP match, and I wonder if we will see Dark Templars yet again, because we saw Dark Templars in almost every Protoss game so far, so I hope this will be something different, and for once I'm hoping for a longer game. The only longer game we had was Steam Hammer versus Iron, and the others were decided quickly. And defensive play from Purple Wave with cannons. I don't know what is Purple Wave expecting or not expecting, but yeah, quite a lot of cannons. No, just two. I thought this was a cannon as well, but alas, it is not. I don't know how intentional this layout of buildings is, but they form a kind of a wall, and they they force you to go the long way around, but still I don't know if it's intentional or not, but it turns out to be quite a defensive sim city. And another cannon, is this a cannon? Yes it is. So no, that's a pylon, I was wrong. Four cannons and three zealots are trying to break in. Only three. Three more on the way, I presume. I see only two on the way. There is the third. One zealot. I don't know where it is. Doesn't matter. Purple Wave is just defending as hard as he can. And what is the plan? Citadel of Adun. Maybe we will see the Dark Templars finally. I can't really tell. This is a stalemate at this point, although only six zealots here. It's moving around, makes it hard to count, to be honest. UI Alberto bot is quite ahead in supply, and but Purple Wave is ahead in workers, and sitting quite comfortably behind this wall of just a few cannons, but still at this stage of the game they can repel this attack, I believe. But it seems that we will not find that out. Oh, or maybe we will do. No, we don't. They don't commit to the engagement, and there is a Templar archives. And yes, the Dark Templars are on the way. And they are starting to blast down these zealots here. I don't think you should send in your zealots because there is no detection, so there is no risk of engaging the attacking zealots. But Purple Wave does anyway, and Purple Wave has the purple color for once. So it is gateway units and Dark Templars, three of them. And only zealots from UI Albertobot. I don't see any other unit produced ever, besides workers, of course. Only zealots, and just now taking the second base. Oh, nice, Sim City. I mean, it looks pretty, but that's all. And where are the Dark Templars? Oh, there they are. I don't think UI Albertobot is prepared for that. It is not producing anything that can detect like at all. So, well, this is yet again a Dark Templar game. I think if you are planning on planning to take on Protoss players, Dark Templar play is something you have to be on the lookout for. And at this point, I'm calling the GG. Up next, we have a PvT. It is Iron versus Turchin, and maybe we don't see Dark Templars now. I'm getting tired of Dark Templars, to be honest. And yeah, that's a classic walling off by Iron with the lifting barracks as well. And a quick expansion by Turchin. And in the meantime, I'm wondering if, well, Iron is pretty much always going for a mech build with vultures transitioning into tanks, and Turchin, I see, has a lot of different builds. So, but as said before, Turchin is a Locutus fork, so the builds are not entirely Turchin's merit. And the scouting SCV is kind of denied, but I think it could sneak in. It is exactly as fast as the zealots, I believe, but the dragoon can shoot it down. First vulture is out, no spider mines as of yet, but siege mode is on the way. And there are no defenses to speak of. Only one marine, one vulture, and one tank. Okay, one tank can stand against one dragoon even without siege mode, and siege mode is high on the priority list, as you can see here, and we will have siege mode in a second. In the meantime, nice walling off by Turchin. I quite like this SimCity. This map yet again is one when you can just do that. And it seems that Turchin is going for a gateway army and not much else, which can work, don't get me wrong. In the meantime, do we have, yes, we have Spider-Man research. Sieging and sieging going on, a little bit weird place for the tanks, but it works. They are on the high ground above the ramp, so they will cover the entrance quite well. What we often say that very few bots use high ground effectively, and Iron is no exception. I don't think the high ground usage here is intentional, and the sieging and sieging is just wacky. Again, a lot of bots do that, unfortunately. It's probably some evaluation triggering all the way. That you should siege, then unsiege, then you siege and unsiege, but it is my belief that tanks should be sieged as much as possible, because yeah, that's when they deal the big damages. And the first carrier is out. I didn't pay a lot of attention to Turchin's base, but it seems it's a two base carrier build yet again. So it will just play out like it did the last time. I'm sorry, there are not many bots, so the combinations are not many as well. And there will be repeat matchups. And this one carrier is just devastating. No, you don't have any anti-air, no Goliaths to speak of. There wasn't even an attempt to do that. Halfway done, science facility, well, not halfway, but incomplete science facility, let's say. Well, this was quite anticlimactic. Let's just quickly jump into the next game. Okay, the first ZVZ, I believe it's a Microwave versus ZZK bot, and I'm really hoping this will be not a degenerate game. And well, I'm sorry, this is just a joke, don't take me seriously. I commend the effort of every bot developer, I can't say that enough. Joking at the bots and maybe wacky plays is by no means criticizing the hard work and effort these authors put in, so handle it with care. So it is a few zerglings and the few defensive structures for ZZK bot, and what do we have here? A spawning pool quite late, and Microwave is not doing much, a lot of workers though. Well, late spawning pool in a ZVZ game, not too late in general. Nice worker defense, and the first zerglings of Microwaves are out. And the Microwave got the worst of this engagement. As you can see, ZZK bot has more workers and more income. So this zerling pressure was nice, and ZZK bot managed to sneak in a few sunken colonies as well. And quite nicely done. I don't know what Microwave was doing in the meantime. Maybe one sunken colony would have been beneficial. And this is just running into the sunken colonies and dying. Yeah, that's not a sustainable tactic long term. Another sunken for Microwave, but the player's basically using the same things. No, a spire is finally out, so Mutalisk can effectively kill this base because there is absolutely no anti-air, and ZZK bot is not doing anything else than zerglings and sunken colonies, which is fine if you are fighting ground units, but I believe that very soon that will not be the case. Yes, the first few zerglings, Mutalisks are on the way. What is this? What do we have here? What are you producing, dear ZZK? It is a spire, but it is too late. Is it a spire? Oh, it is a spire. It is here. And Mutalisks just devastate the worker line. No more workers left. And yeah, this is just, well, yet again decided by a simple factor. Yes, ZZK has some Mutalisks on it. Of its own, but yeah, that's not gonna save you. Well, with that quick ZVZ, let's jump into the next game. So it is Macrave versus Xiaoyi in a very weird map. I didn't see this map before, to be honest, but let's see how it turns out. And I don't know the name of this map, I have to look it up. Unfortunately, this replay viewer does not display it for me, and the replay name wasn't really helpful either. So, Xiaoyi in this quite wacky little position here. We have some neutral buildings, I don't know if this opens at all. This neutral X reminiscent of the famous map Plasma. And well, this is just weird, and I think this is supposed to be maybe something reminiscent of a Korean flag, but don't quote me on this. Maybe it's just a good looking symbol. I don't actually really know how the Korean flag looks, but it's something like that. Whatever, let's just watch the game. Vangoon is out for Macrave, shutting down the scouting. And Ziaoyi is just bunkering up. Nice SimCity here. I don't know exactly what the intention. You could have just did it here, and that would have been much more effective, or even here. But maybe map analysis is not working properly, or maybe it was the plan all along to have a bunker protecting your mineral line. I mean, I can see the rationale behind that. But in the meantime, a few vultures are out, well, one and two vultures are out, but still, and moons are skirmishing a little bit, and that is a bunker. Yes, that is a bunker. So, Dark Templars, yes, Dark Templars, yet again Dark Templars. It is about Dark Templars this year, ladies and gentlemen. It is the year of the Dark Templar. So, no detection to speak of, no academy. I think we all know where this is going. I would like to see a game without Dark Templars now, but this is not something I will see, it seems. And this is... no, that's a science facility. Or is it? No, it's an armory. Still, it is not an academy. And you have two armories, which is very nice, but still, none of those armories can see the Dark Templars. And yes, this game is just over. So it is Macrave versus Ziaoyi in a very weird map. I didn't see this map before, to be honest, but let's see how it turns out. And I don't know the name of this map, I have to look it up. Unfortunately, this replay viewer does not display it for me, and the replay name wasn't really helpful either. So Ziaoyi in the in this quite a wacky little position here. We have some neutral buildings. I don't know if this opens at all. This neutral X, reminiscent of the famous map Plasma. And well, this is just weird. And yeah, I think this is supposed to be maybe something of reminiscent of a Korean flag, but don't quote on me on this. Maybe it's just good looking symbol. I don't actually really know how the Korean flag looks, but it's something like that. Whatever, let's just watch the game. Vangoon is out for Macrave, shutting down the scouting. And Ziaoyi is just bunkering up. Nice SimCity here. I don't know exactly what the intention. You could have just did it here, and that would have been much more effective, or even here. But maybe map analysis is not working properly, or maybe it was the plan all along to have a bunker protecting your mineral line. I mean, I can see the rationale behind that. But in the meantime, a few vultures are out, well, one and two vultures are out, but still, and moons are skirmishing a little bit. And that is a bunker. Yes, that is a bunker. So, Dark Templars. Yes, Dark Templars. Yet again, Dark Templars. It is about Dark Templars this year, ladies and gentlemen. It is the year of the Dark Templar. So, no detection to speak of, no academy. I think we all know where this is going. I would like to see a game without Dark Templars now, but this is not something I will see, it seems. And this is... no, that's a science facility. Or is it? No, it's an armory. Still, it is not an academy. And you have two armories, which is very nice, but still, none of those armories can see the Dark Templars. And yes, this game is just over. Thank you for watching this week's broadcast. My name is Shonko, and I have a site called makingcomputerdothings.com, where I blog about bot development and have a podcast about the same topic. Check it out if you're interested. Thanks again, and goodbye.